we are messing around with harmonizer, filter, octaves, delays, just a lot of stuff going on in terms of the programming in the pedal board today for the practice room. Making these, I'm so happy to be making these kind of sounds. I was up until 4 o'clock this morning doing some programming in the Eventide H9, and I've got a bunch of presets for four-part harmony. Shout out to great bass player Zach Reiser, who hipped me to the fact that the H9 could do four-part harmony. I had no idea. I was just busy complaining to him that there were no pedals out there that did four-part harmony. How wrong was I? Not only was I wrong, but I owned the pedal. So, right, I was just experimenting before I put the camera on, and I was like, oh man, I've got the filter before the pitch shifting. This is still very ghetto in terms of the routing and everything in my pedal board. And I was like, damn it, got the filter before the pitch shifting, so I can't take the chord and then push that through the filter. But what I'm doing is putting the Dubterranea with, I've got a triangle wave right now going on, into the filter. So I'm kind of getting the triangle wave thing filtered and then pushing that through the Eventide. I'm loving these sounds. Now the question is, can I coordinate my right foot with the expression pedal to filter sweep while at the same time looping with the left? We're about to find out, I guess. Yes. Now I'm going to get rid of the filter. I'm also going to go down a patch and grab something that has let me stop there for a second. I'm going to change voicings because I want that F voicing right there, has a little more crunch to it, but I want to wash it out and only put it over one chord, over the F. So I'm just building things here, as you can hear. This is all kind of happening in real time, experimenting with it all a little bit. I also, of course, want to play you a bunch of the, let me see, where are we? If I go here, here, still got pitch shifting. Why have I still got pitch shifting? This is going to be quite the task to put it all in MIDI and have all these things set up to go where they need to go at the same time. And also selecting the Eventide presets. Haven't done any work with MIDI with Eventide yet. And being able to select the Eventide and the HX Stomp and make them both do what I need them to do at the same time. Go to delays and processing and filters and stuff with the HX Stomp, but throwing all the harmonizer stuff into it from the H9. So, I'll show you just clean what these sound like. Nothing else but the H9 on right now. I'll go up and show I've got some minor ones as well. Kind of can't live without the delay. Really, where is it? Cycle through a couple of these minor ones. Got rid of the lower octave there. If I go back to the previous one, you can hear the lower octave. Huge spread, right? And then if I go back up, get rid of the lower octave. Until right now, with the highs boosted a little bit to really push the chord out. But I kind of like that more rounded sound when I cut a little bit of the highs and the EQ of the bass and go back to active mode. Okay, let's go up one more. Let's see what we got here. Woo! Super low. So I don't have the high octave. I dropped, I think, the minor third down into the middle of the voicing. I'm also using the iPad to do the programming because it's way easier visually speaking. And it's all hooked up via Bluetooth. Okay, it was hooked up via Bluetooth. Let's go in here, select H9. Pretty easy. There seems to be a little bug in the system. It's not allowing me to directly save the presets to the stomp box. Let's see now. Presets, yes. So what do I have? I have the lower octave, then the fourth, then the seventh, and then, yeah, the lower third. So I'm taking a, instead of the tenth, it's the third in this one. Two. Oh, my DI just fell over. Look. Lovely. Okay. And what about if I put the triangle wave into that and filter it? Breaking up a little bit at the end? Much fun. Okay, really nice to be able to check these things out as I hear them in my brain and then try and put them into reality. What do we got next? Another minor one. Oh, double octave down now. This is the biggest spread, I think. Is that what I called it? Of course, I didn't name it the right way. Yeah, so it's double octave down. Oh, hang on a second. Hang on. So I've got the double octave down, the fourth, the seventh, and the tenth. Let's try that with the filter again. Woo! That is awesome. Okay. Now I'm really excited to get these as presets in the ES5, in the switcher, just to be able to instantly go to that specific combination. So all I'm dealing with peripherally is either the volume pedal or the expression pedal. I'd like to be able to make one selection, maybe have a bank of things in different keys, have a bank of C major, bank of C minor, bank of D flat, major, D flat minor, and so on. Mm. Wow, and there is so many options. What there isn't an option for, what there seems, maybe somebody can correct me on this, what there seems to not be an option for in the Quadravox on the H9 is like a non-diatonic thing, like a parallel thing, like just being able to design one voicing and that voicing be the same no matter where you take it on the instrument, whether that be from the top down or the bottom up. That's kind of a bummer. I would like that option. Let's see. Oh, what is this? So this is some D Dorian, but like one, what is this? 1 9 10. Okay, 1 9 10 7, exactly, yeah. And then I did a variation on this so I could get to the two without it clashing. Hearing the Otto Bit Junior, that kind of that great pedal by Meris, I'm thinking that might be the next thing to go in the board to process that in time. I guess with tap tempo and whatever, and being able to do step sequencing, filtering, and all of that kind of stuff, and stutter, and all kinds of random stuff, and octave leaps, and now if I put the super shifter in there and did maybe a momentary switch for the octave, that could be super cool as well. Basically, I think I said this in an interview recently or just in a post on maybe YouTube or something, that everyone's like, oh man, you're just a frustrated guitar player because you play high in the dusty end of the neck, the high register of the instrument. Actually, I think I'm way more of a soon to be less frustrated, but nonetheless frustrated synth fan. I mean, these are the things I'm trying to program on a keyboard when I go to make cool sounds. Now, what did I have before? That seems like so long ago. Let me scrub that actually. Let me go in passive again. Again, the combination, left foot, right foot. I already messed it up right away. Thinking too much. Mm-hmm. I think I might be blowing out the recording just slightly here. I would hate to finish recording an hour of this stuff and then just listen to it and it'd be farting around. Let's get to... Oops. What do we got going on here? Pitch shifting. Find a sound that I want to maybe just clean. Probably need a little more juice on that. Now that becomes very weak. Let's see. Also, like gain structure and the balance of all of this stuff in the board is super key. I definitely don't have that dialed in. Right now it feels like everything's kind of maxed out. I'm pushing all of the effects too much. And when I come back to my natural bass sound, it's a little bit light. Maybe if I boost in the room a little bit and turn down the... off a little steam. That was not the definitely was not the original focus of today's practice session. Okay, what's happening here? See, now troubleshooting on the go. That's what I'm most impressed about. Like pushing the synth pedal through the harmonizer. Was not expecting that. Let's get rid of the synth pedal for a second. Yeah, it just doesn't have the effect. What I really want to do now is switch out the harmonizer, the position of it in the chain, and put it... It'd be awesome to... Let's see if I can do this quickly. All right, I'm gonna do it and I'm gonna explain what I'm doing as I do it. Hopefully nothing's gonna go bang, pop, fizz, and crunch. Let's see if I can do this. So, the HX stomp goes back to being the last thing in the signal chain before obviously the freeze and the loopers, the pedals that are just collecting information. They're not actually adding information to the sound. So now I need to put the H9 before, this should be simple, right? Before the zero graph, but after the dub terrania. That is That's what's got to happen. Now, gazillion dollar question, do I have the cables to do it right this second? Probably not. Let's see. Let's turn that around for starters. Always a lack of the right size patch cables. That always pisses me off. And the wife is on the phone. Hey, babe. What's happening? I would love to, but I'm right in the middle of filming an episode for the practice room. Yeah, it's okay. But give me about 10 minutes and let's go do that. All right, bye. Okay. He requests to be active with the dog outside our little quarantine exercise situation that we get happening once a day to get some fresh air. And look, this gaunt look doesn't happen without some work. So I can't stay inside all the time. Okay. God damn it. What do I need? I need that. Yes. Okay, I got one cable. Success. One cable. Yes. Okay. Let's do this. The return. Send. Input. One. Return. One. And that is now in number two. Okay, that was not so crazy. And if I go edit this patch, turn loop two on, and then the chain has to look like 4, 2, 5. There we go. So I got to just move two up. All right. Maybe that was way less complicated than I thought it was going to be. Let's find out. Of course, now there's no sound. What's going on? What is going on? Is that why? Nope. Hate it when it does this. God damn it. I've probably got something crossed. Do I have those crossed? Nope. I think I had them right the first time. Ah, so frustrating. That's what happens in the experimentation stages of all this stuff. I don't even have a through sound right now, so something is majorly screwed up. Hey! There it is. Okay, so let's now use the iPad to move around here. So if I take out the synth, so the whole point of doing this was so that I could filter the eventide with the filter coming after the eventide in the chain. Okay, do I even like that now? Synth back on. The crazy thing is, I'm not sure if I even like it that way round. Isn't that weird, huh? But what I do love is just the quality of the sound. I think this is going to be a pretty awesome pairing, using the H9 for the harmonizing and then the HX stomp for all the processing, like maybe some of the filtering. I'm not sure about the filtering yet. I did put this tremolo. Yes. That's an H9, that's a HX stomp rather, tremolo. Pretty aggressive. And then I put some, what, delay and reverb in there? Is that what that is? That's... Oh yeah, that's long as well. Wow, okay. Yeah. So in general, I'm super happy with these sounds. And this is what happens. This is what days are like here at home. I'd like to say this is what quarantine days are like, but this is what most days are like, regardless of whether there's a global pandemic going on. Just trying to figure out new weird sounds. Let's see. Nice having the iPad. Woo. Now, let me show you this. I just have a page of presets like that. That makes it quite easy to get to. I'm not sure I'll ever really want to have an iPad on stage like that. Maybe too distracting. I'm not sure. I don't know if I'm that guy. Always kind of shy away from that kind of tactile hand thing, but having said that, probably next week I'll be making a video about how to integrate the laptop or the iPad into the live show. Anyway, for now, it's at least nice for programming to and for figuring it out. I just feel like I want to be in the middle of lines and be able to switch that. Interesting. And then I did have an inversion somewhere. Where is that? It's also a question of like keeping track of it all as well has not been, I'm not the best at that. But you know, it's a work in progress. Pretty happy though. Oh, so now can I bypass? No, okay. It'd be nice to be able to instantly bypass with the iPad. I'd probably do that with the pedal, I'm sure. Is that active? Yeah, active bypass, okay. So many moving parts, right? When it was so much easier when it was just one button on a stomp box. Possibilities are just incredible now. Gosh, I probably attuned before I did any of this as well. I kind of did this morning when I was shedding. Let's see, how do I get back to that? So much going on this pedal board right now. What do we... Practice today. Remember that I'm still a bass player. So maybe the pedal studio needs to have an episode where I break down the harmonizer stuff, do some close-ups and slow-mo and all the rest of it, the high-end production stuff for the harmonizer. But I'm still working on it, so not really close to that yet. Maybe a couple, 2-3 weeks out. Don't forget, leave me some comments below this video. Especially if you also watch the pedal studio, always looking for feedback in terms of what to do next in terms of pedals to feature or signal chains, that kind of stuff. Yeah, don't underestimate the power of giving the video a thumbs up. Really helps me to make more free videos like this and to grow the channel. And that's it. Oh, quick note. Teletronics TDI. Check this out. This is what you've been hearing me record all of this bass with today and the last episode of the Pedal Studio and a bunch of other things in recent weeks. Actually partnered with this company, with Teletronics, that make this lovely DI to sell the last remaining units of a very short run they did. There's a link in the description below this video. If you use the discount code YanekSentMe20, you get a $20 discount off the purchase price of the DI. Full disclosure, I do get a commission if you purchase it and use that discount code. And yeah, please, comments below. Conversation is always open. Love to read your comments, love to answer your questions. So don't let that slow down at all. I'm gonna get back to modular synth heaven down here with these pedals, and see you guys on the next episode.